Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today I am going to talk about health. It's a health strategy. How to achieve the good health. It's one of the most important subject. If you have a good health, really you don't need much anything from the world. But to maintain good health, it's a difficult job. So, how to achieve the good health? Number one, health is so precious, it is better than 1,000 gifts of Allah. So, but to maintain one health, you have to sacrifice 1,000 things also. It cannot come for free, nothing is free. One has to work very hard for the health. And it's the most complex and complicated subject in the world. Believe me, throughout my life, 30 years I'm in the profession, really I've seen good health in two people. It's so rare, rarest of the rare. One was a British Air Force pilot, and other one is a prince from Saudi Arabia. So, both of them really have a good health. Otherwise, you know, something or the other, it happens. So, I'm just simply telling you what you have to do. If you can maintain five principles, inshallah, you will get good health. That is, alkaline diet, exercise, physical therapy, rest and sleep, and vital medical parameters. Alkaline means you have to eat 30% of the acidic food, 70% alkaline food. And exercises, you have to be very careful. You can't do just go and exercise and achieve goals. No, you have to see many things. You have to see your stress level, you have to see your sleep pattern, you have to see the change of weather, what is happening, you know, change of weather. Mostly people fall sick during change of weather. 30% people die of heart attack and a stroke during change of weather, so be careful. And also if you don't sleep well, you have a lot of stress, go for a walk, take a rest, sleep, that's better. The sleep will bring good health. So not all the time the exercise are bringing good health. Many people are in the gym, in the tennis court. Just doing running, jogging, just doing exercise, they are dying. So you have to be very careful about this. Third one is the physical therapy, what we do. That is the massage, physical therapy. If you take it is a professional massage, not just, if you take a professional massage, those who knows, they are a physical therapist, they will massage. So they will come to know what is happening to your body, where is the pain, many things. And it will increase circulation, it will help you to go to good sleep. So fourth one is the rest and sleep. Take enough rest and sleep. It's very important. These days I would recommend maybe 8 to 9 hours of sleep. Earlier it used to be 7, it's fine, but you need a good sleep. Sleep has a good remedy. And vital medical parameters. Time to time you have to see what is happening to your body. I mean your BP, your sugar, your cholesterol level, many things. Also I would advise once in a year or once in 6 months, go for the ultrasound, see what is happening inside your body. You know, there are people develop kidney stone, people develop gallbladder stone, and organs are fine or not. There is swelling in the liver. Many things you need to know. So ultrasound, I would advise. So these five principles if you follow, and I'm sure that you will achieve good health. So, another few points, I have an article about the health target. So, I'm going to tell you some points from this health target. So that, disruption of the nerves regarding food is so meticulously planned that sometimes the most intelligent of people cannot refrain from consuming unhealthy foods. Your stomach, kidneys, pancreas, heart and liver are the victims of your choices. They have no power to make you eat the food that you do, but they forcibly have to digest and become abnormal when you ingest food. Your tongue is your biggest enemy in life. I mean, talking and eating both start from the tongue. And every way it will make you forget this act of julm. It is same as how the eyes forget to not look at the wrong things and cause spiritual drainage. complete focus of Sunnah of Nabi Pak Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the only way to protect from victimizing organs further. They are the victims of your choices. Your organs are victims of your choices. And man, until kills himself, is not satisfied. Continuing this lifelong julm, he doesn't even see it as a big julm. Unfortunately, organs are not your slaves. They are disciplined, but to retaliate upon long-term provocation and oppressive as anyone would. Allah has put life in each of them to function independently. The internal organs, Allah has made them systematic and they're very independent, very organized. But I don't know, we damage them. Health is a top priority. This doesn't cross our minds, not focus at all. Mind is bombarded with many other thoughts. Lots of laziness has spread in the body, so the body is not ready to do any physical activities or exercises. Body is badly addicted and affected with laziness and pleasure. People are lazy because of pleasure, eating too much. Pleasure, lazy. They don't want to do anything. Not even thinking about yoga, walking, or going to gym, or taking massage. And some people, because of high BP and diabetes, their body is too lethargic. So don't want to do. There are tough principles to achieve good health. But we are neglecting those and yet want to achieve good health. We want to eat junk food. Many junk foods we eat. So, they damage us. Stress and high blood pressure is a silent killer. So, monitor them regularly. Never know when or how they are going to destroy us. If your stomach is upset, your mind will be disturbed, which will affect your sleep and consequently cause overthinking. Unhealthy stomach will irritate your piles and throat. And also sometimes, you know, wrong eating can lead to cancer. I am surprised with some people whose health condition is bad. Their digestive system is wrecked, skin bad, victims of bad breath, joint pain has spread throughout their body. They have zero knowledge about calories, but continue to eat as they please with zero cell discipline. Have long ignored their health and are not taking or focused towards the preventive measures at all. May Allah forgive them and shower His blessings and mercy on them. Last few words about health. Remain ultra focused to your thoughts and desires. It is from there all disasters arise. Never forget the real situation of your stomach and never knowingly or unknowingly try and damage. Be sincere, do exercises, walking, yoga, hard work, but do not get stressed. Abstain from food without a clear concept of calories count in it, sugar content and overall quality. Always keep the mind alert of any mistakes committed in thinking, understanding and deciding. Then remember the severe consequences that are going to strike. So, common sense must be applied in all petty matters. So this is a few guidance. I'm going to talk more about health, whatever. Today I think it's almost 10 minutes. So, Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bismillah.